Hey, what do Elon Musk, Mark Zuckerberg, Bill Gates, J.K. Rowling, Bedros Keuilian, and me, Craig Ballantyne, all have in common? We're all introverts, but we also have a massive network. And even though we're not all billionaires, we're at least millionaires, and we're gonna teach you the Introvert's Guide to Networking. All right, so years ago, I was a broke, struggling, introverted, socially anxious, binge-drinking personal trainer who didn't want to be any of those things. And I realized the only way for me to get out of there was by knowing more people who could lift me up. So if you're stuck at home and you live in a small town, or maybe even if you live in a big city, but you don't feel like you don't have a lot of friends, you love spending time alone, and you hear about all these people who are out there schmoozing and networking, and you think that's the only way to be successful, well, the good thing is, it's not true. It's not true at all. I'm gonna walk you through at least four, maybe five steps to getting the ultimate guide just by being an introvert so that you can grow to millions and maybe even be the next billionaire. So the very first thing that you have to do is lead with value. Back when I was in college and I wanted to start growing my network, what I did was I had an email list. And I started interviewing other experts in my field. Now I was able to get their message in front of thousands of people. And by doing that, they started referring me to other people. They started promoting my products when I was selling information on the internet. And I call that friends making money with friends. So it's called affiliate marketing in the world of e-com. And again, I started out with nothing. I was a struggling farm boy, became a personal trainer, build up a little bit of an email list through good content, just like you're building up your social media through good content, and then you probably hit a wall. And that wall can be overcome through other people. So again, add value first. Figure out whether it's in person in your neighborhood, or whether it's online, whether it's somebody that you're connecting with, even if they're rich and famous, by adding value to them, you'll get in their network. For example, my friend Joel Marion, he's been a coaching client of mine for over 10 years. The guy runs a $100 million a year company. And when he came to me, he didn't know anybody, but he started adding value to other people. Then he hired me. There's a bit of a pay to play in growing your network as well. So he invested in me. I helped him grow his network. Years later, once he became famous with over a million followers on Instagram, Joel started getting a lot of messages from this young guy named Richard. Richard was an introvert, but he was doing reviews of Joel's podcast and just always telling all of his friends and family about the show and tagging Joel in his Instagram stories. Sure enough, Joel would promote Richard in his Instagram stories, and eventually Richard begged Joel for a job. Now, Joel didn't have a job, but Joel introduced him to another entrepreneur, Vince Del Monte, another client of mine, and Vince was able to hire Richard on and give Richard the job of his dreams. And eventually Richard will become a millionaire, and definitely a multimillionaire, if not a billionaire, through that network, all by adding value first. So again, it doesn't matter, especially in this day and age, if you live in a small town, if you don't know anybody, you can go and add value even to people that have so much money that you think they're out of reach. But you do have to be persistent. Richard sent Joel over 50 messages, but didn't stop until Joel got back to him. So that's one thing that you can do. Another thing that I did with my friend Bedros Keuilian, who's a business partner and also a client of mine, I'm a client of his. We run masterminds together. And what Bedros and I did is we started sending books to each other in the mail. We didn't know each other. We had never met in person, but we respected each other's work. And so I would send him a book and say, hey, Bedros, you got to read this. He would send me a book back. And then one day we decided, you know what, let's meet in person and see if it's a good fit for us to grow a mastermind. Sure enough, we did. And we had a seven-figure mastermind program, a little nice side business because we had other businesses to run, all through that introverted networking. So think about how you can show up in a positive, value-adding way for strangers. You might go and edit their sales pages. You might write some email copy for them. You might go and do an audit of their Instagram. You could do all of these things, offer to apprentice for them, and sure enough, one of these opportunities will come your way. So you have to realize, if you don't show up with your best work every single day, you're not consistent, dependable, and reliable, they're going to find somebody else to take your place. You're an interchangeable part at this point, and you have to be the person they can depend on. All right, so growing your millionaire network isn't all about just knowing millionaires. It's about surrounding yourself with people that make you play up a level in life. So if you're hanging out right now with people that smoke weed and stay up all night and don't do anything with their lives and just are absolutely negative and takers, well, you need to change your social circle. You need to hang around people that make you play up that level. And whether it's starting to go to the gym and hang around people that are stronger and fitter than you, or hanging around people that have better relationships than you, or hanging around people who get more work done, or hang around people that make more money, or hang around people that have greater morals and ethics than your friends, you need to start hanging around those people to lift you up, because you are the average of the five people that you spend the most time with. And if you spend a lot of time with people that are struggling in their own lives and a negative influence on you, then you're gonna fall down the rabbit hole of losing your habits, losing your faith and commitment to what you're trying to achieve, and eventually just losing your motivation. So make sure that you up-level your own personal network. Now, how do you do that as an introvert? First thing is that you need to live and lead by extreme example. And so back when I was a introverted, socially anxious, binge drinking personal trainer, I decided no more drinking. I am going to go all in on my health. And I decided to live and lead by extreme example. I started to get up earlier. I started to work harder. And I started to attract more people like that into my life. I started writing more emails consistently. I started adding more value to other people. And sure enough, I got into these relationships with people that I didn't think were possible just a couple years earlier. I thought everybody partied on the weekend. I thought everybody lived like a frat boy until they were 30. I thought everybody was hungover on Saturday and Sunday until I met these people who wanted more in their lives. And by hanging around people who wanted more, I ended up achieving more as well, and then getting introduced to other people. So yeah, it was hard at first to make a few sacrifices, but the short-term pain equaled long-term gain. All right, so here's the wild card that you have as an introvert. As an introvert, you think a lot, you plan things out, you like to spend time on your own kind of planning and scheming. And so what I want you to do is actually start your own networking groups. In the past, what we had to do is we had to fly to an event, we had to be that introverted person who was really anxious in a group full of other people. You know, I used to go to events back when I was your age, and I would, you know, be so awkward sitting beside somebody. They'd try and start a conversation. I wouldn't know how to chime in, and it'd be like, okay, now it's going to be awkward for the 2 days that I'm sitting beside you. So I ruined a whole bunch of chances. But the cool thing is now what I'm doing is I'm organizing events and bringing people in online. I'm running virtual summits all the time. And sometimes they're small, 15 people, sometimes they're 100 people, but they're a great opportunity to be the leader. So this is, goes back to kind of living and leading by extreme example. If you can go and figure out something where you can add value, and then you can get somebody else to come and add value, and then you can say, hey, listen, I'm bringing together this expert and myself, and we're talking about something that's gonna help you, whether you wanna write a book, or whether you wanna help people with fitness, or whether you wanna get together a bunch of entrepreneurs, now you're gonna be the hub. And you're gonna say, I'm organizing this event, it's free. All you have to do is just make sure you commit to showing up and adding value. And everyone's gonna go, wow, thanks so much. What can I do for you? What can I do for you? And that's going and giving with the giving hand in this day and age of digital. Now you can also have a podcast where you can invite people on. And yeah, as an introvert, it's gonna be rough, but it's a whole lot easier than meeting people in person. So you can have those great questions, grow your podcast, get people in front of your audience. And that type of approach is what adds value to other people. They then say, hey, can I help you get some more guests for your show? Of course, that's what you wanna get. And little by little, you're gonna grow that network, which allows you to expand your opportunities. All right, the last thing that I want to do is a little methodical. And you'll need to make three columns. So whether you do it in a Google Doc or whether you do it on paper, it doesn't matter. But you're going to make what my friend Russell Brunson calls your dream 100. Who are the 100 people that you want to have in your network? Who do you want to be connected with? Whether it's in your industry or whether it's just a mover and shaker in the celebrity world, or whether it's someone who can add value to you, or whether it's someone that you simply look up to in their personal lives. You make that list of 100 people. Now, in the middle column, you're going to leave that blank. In the third column, you're going to identify what's the one step or the one person that can make that introduction. Then you go back to that middle column and you identify something that you can do to add value to that person. So let's say it was Tony Robbins, and maybe you know somebody who's been to a Tony Robbins event. Well, listen, that's a long way from Tony Robbins, but you can add value to this person over here who can then maybe make an introduction to somebody they met at Tony's event who worked for Tony. And then you add value to that person who maybe makes the introduction to Tony. When you're able to do that type of planning and preparation, you can build your network. So make that list, that Dream 100, then make a list of the people that can connect you with them, and then figure out how you can add that value. That's what an introvert can do at home, under quarantine, with only social media, with pretty much nothing at your disposal. You can grow $1 million and eventually a $1 billion network. Today, I'm in a mastermind group with 100 millionaires. Most of them make over $10 million. It's pretty much a $1 billion network just within that group. And that doesn't count the hundreds of other entrepreneurs that I've coached, that I've been in mastermind groups with, that are at my disposal on my newsletter list that I can connect with at almost any time. And it comes from humble beginnings. Again, grew up on a farm, broke, nothing, had all of those negative qualities, had to overcome a lot of things, including being an introvert, which I actually used to my advantage, and you can too, to become a millionaire. Listen, I wanna hear your success story. So either drop it down below about how you used one of those tips to be successful, or go to craigballantyne.com if you wanna work with me, get into my network, and grow your opportunities and become a millionaire, just like all those successful people who were once introverts like you too.